pastor's anniversary.
Good evening, how are you all doing? This was my idea, this was my husband's idea. They say the man's supposed to be the lead, so we are here today.
Oh,
Yeah. First of all, let me say this. Do you do everything right? No. Only Jesus can. And he will help you to do it. Do your best. Do you have joy all the time? No. Are you peaceful all the time? No. Then who is? Are you right all the time?
But if mom there understand it, he wants to be there. He said he got me because money gonna try to get his dad to fight. About 4 years, most of them are the church. He already said, me and him, he kind of relate to a lot. Last year, me and him got a chance to hang out down the line, $7 Super Bowl, and we celebrated like that was our last time. We went to the Pastor Faze and some other people Faze, so staying like the pastor, he don't like the blues. So he came to me a couple weeks ago at work, and he said, you know what, Chris, some of us, man. But I like when people come to me and say, I can't do something. Mm-hmm. I like to make me work harder on proving wrong. And that was the first thing I said earlier in the service today. She said something similar to that. You can tell that he came from the first man. Because the first man, pastor, all of them the same frame. Mm-hmm. And Stanley, every time you see him, he got that smile on your face, joke, laugh. He told me one day, if you can't call me Big Stan, I'm calling him Larry. He always did it last. I get a word from him. I said, Stan, you're talking about that McDonald's. I'm telling you, Dad, you look at me, ball his fist up at me. I said, I'll answer Stan, a good person. He's a hard worker. Like I said, I can talk to my little brother, and I always tell him, you need anybody to talk to, or you don't feel comfortable talking to anybody, just come to me. I've got the best way I can, the best way I know how. Once again, you know, you wouldn't even be, you have to work, and that's not all. I mean, y'all can be proud of, but we all be talking knowledge of your mom and dad. He gonna kill me if I can not tell y'all this, though. He said, when you first started the new show, Eddie came through the parking lot, pretending he was done or something. That's what I get. And I told my dad, he was checking up on me.
Experience loss at a major cost. to love God and we just do what we do. Amen. But let me introduce my husband. I'm honored to be his wife just as much as he is honored to be my husband.
Say what you have to say through me today, Father, in the name of Jesus. And oh Satan, we let you know that we bind you, all of your works, your distractions, you will not be successful. We bind you in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We praise you in advance for your word. It is in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. When you get that word, when you please stand to your feet as we give reverence to the word of God. That's Psalms 37, start at the 23rd verse. Does everyone have it? And it reads, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and the delight in his way. And he delighted his way. Though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, for the Lord upholdeth him with his hand. I have been young and not am old, yet have I not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. He is ever merciful, he liveth, and his seed is blessed. Depart from evil and do good, and dwell forevermore. For the Lord loveth judgment, and forsake not his saints. They are preserved forever, but the seed of the wicked shall be cut off. We're going to use for our subject or our thought today. I don't believe he brought you this far to leave you. You may be seated. Different things, and as he does different things, we have to stay encouraged and know that God will not leave us, nor will he forsake us. God told me to tell you today that he still got your back. When everybody turned their back on you, when everybody walked out on you, when people don't understand why you say and do what you say and do, know that God got your back. And when, as long as God got your back, Pastor, you don't need nobody else. God got your back today. The late Reverend James Cleveland wrote a song entitled, I'm Not Tired Yet. I don't believe he brought me this far to leave me. When Reverend Cleveland started his song, he said he was in a church and a little old lady that was about 82 years old got up to testify. She said, I've been running for Jesus some 50 some odd years. She continued, y'all have a good man.
Amen.
And I'm not going to say I believe his steps are ordered by the Lord. What I'm going to say is I know, Pastor Colbert, I know your steps are ordered by the Lord. It's a powerful thing when you got a man of God, amen, that allows God to lead him, guide him, and direct him, amen. Follow the directions of God, amen.
Amen.
Pastor Coleman might want to do it one way, but God says, you got to do it the other way. Because you know if you do it your way ain't going to make it. It won't last. If you have been doing things your way for 21, you wouldn't have been doing it for 21 years. Because it would not have lasted. But when you allow God to be your sure foundation, when you allow God to be your sure foundation and you build your house upon a sure foundation, I don't care what kind of gates of hell come against it, guess what? They're not going to prevail. Devil in hell himself can try and push it down. He can try to be the big bad wolf himself, and he can huff and he can puff all he wants to. But you got a house that ain't made of straw. You got a rock, amen. You got a piece of the rock, amen. You got Jesus. This house is built upon Jesus. Somebody say Jesus.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. I don't believe he brought brought you this far to leave you.